Welcome, Scott.
All right, thank you. Hey. So my name is Scott Whitaker. I'm a membership expert, and I'll tell you a little bit about myself. Let me just ask, I know after hearing a number of you earlier today, and you bring in a lot of national speakers and so forth. So let me just ask, how many of you believe that I'm going to try to sell you something during our time together? All right, I will not disappoint you, I promise. All right, but here's what's going to make my presentation and my time with you different than maybe some of your speakers. Your speakers, they come in, they tell you about the why, they tell you about the what, they get you emotionally charged and build up this emotional connection. They give you a call to action, and then everybody goes to the back of the room, and then a couple days later, you're just looking, maybe looking back over your notes and saying, they really didn't tell me how. And you're kind of disappointed. You know, you spent all of that time listening to them, you were there, but after the event, you go back and you look to see what you can put into your business, and all of a sudden, there's nothing there. That's not what I'm going to do. As a matter of fact, I'm going to do what they all say you should never do, and that is give the how. And I'm going to give you the how, and I'm going to give you so many next steps that as a result of our time together, you will be able to get new members, you will be able to increase retention, and you will be able to keep people from quitting, so much so that you'll want to join my membership program, pick up my resource. So I'll just be very upfront with you on that notion. So like every speaker, coming up here, I have to show the picture of my family, who are very important to me. This is my wife, my two daughters. Some people ask me, they're like, you know, which one is your wife? And immediately my wife says, that is my best friend there. But my wife and I, somehow or another, produced these two beautiful young blonde girls that we still aren't sure how they got the blonde hair, but we did. And so those are my two daughters. My oldest is 19, my youngest is 14. I'm looking forward to spending Father's Day with them coming this Sunday. My wife and I, we've been married for almost 20 years, or actually almost 21 years. And some of you are saying, well, you know, how young did he get married? He doesn't look old enough. That's one of the reasons why I show this picture. So a little bit about me. I am a big UFC fan. And so some of you, I think you may have heard the announcement, Conor McGregor is finally going to fight Floyd Mayweather. Yes. We can talk about that afterwards. I think Connor is probably going to get his butt kicked. I used to be a model. It's hard to believe now. But yes, that is true. I used to be a model. And I used to be a magician. And I have no tricks for you today. I will not be doing any magic. So there it is. There's my biggest trick. I used to also serve as a pastor. Maybe shocking to some of you. But I actually am currently on staff at a church. I am away from that church this Sunday. I'm an associate pastor at a church. And I have been involved in membership businesses for over 20 years, both as a nonprofit, which the church is a membership business, and for-profit membership businesses as well. It was actually during the time that I went to go out and start a brand new church from scratch. My wife and I, we picked up, moved our family into a city that we didn't know anybody. We just said we just felt like there was a need for a church there. We believed that we were called to that area. Some of you may understand that language, but we had a motivation to go into that community to start a brand new church from scratch. And during that time, I met a pastor who was doing a coaching network for other pastors. I got involved in it, and he said, hey, listen, this is growing. We've got 72 pastors in our coaching network. I need some help. So I said, man, you know, I like it. Obviously, I believe in the stuff that we do, so I'll come on board. And so he and I, we grew that business from 72 pastors to over 3,000 pastors in coaching, became the largest coaching network for pastors in the U.S. that we know of. Took a business that was making six figures and grew it up to over $5 million during our time together. So that's a little bit about me. That's what gets me to this point with you all. I wrote a book. I don't have any copies with me, but you can go to my website and I'll get you a free digital copy, Why People Quit, Your Membership Program, and what you can do about it. So I serve as a coach, a consultant, and what I have for you here today is what I call the seven systems of a growing membership business. Here's what I know. I know nothing about real estate investing. Okay, so I'm just going to be very upfront with you. I don't want to tell you how to do real estate. I don't want to tell you how to, you know, run your meetings or anything like that. What I want you to see by the end of our time together is that you're not only a real estate investor, but you are a membership business owner. You don't just run an association. You just don't run a group of people that come together. You have a membership business. And what I'm going to share with you is all about that particular business. Because here's what I know they don't tell you about investing in real estate. They don't tell you how to run a membership business. They don't. And I've identified seven systems of that exist in every membership business, regardless of their niche. One of the reasons I was able to have the conversation with Rebecca so easily was that she was telling me all about what was going on inside National RIA. I'm able to say, I've heard this conversation before. It was just about this business over here. It was just about this coaching network over here. It was just about that chamber of commerce over here. It's all of the same. So what I'm going to share with you, you're going to be able to transfer into, and I'm going to help you make application into your RIA so that you'll be able to have a systematic approach to running your business. You won't have to guess anymore about what you're going to do from 1 month meeting to the next month meeting. I was listening earlier to some of the, you know, hot topic discussions and trying to solve some of the problems, and that was one of the things that came up is, you know, what do we do next month? So my goal by the end of today and our time together is for you to have a complete year knowing exactly what you're going to do. Now, you might not have everything, you might not have all of the speakers invited, all of that sort of stuff, but you'll be able to have 1 year snapshot of everything that you want to do in your RIA just by organizing it in our systems. So let's talk about systems for a moment. And there's a good reason that I use this up here. I was asked if I wanted to use PowerPoint because that's what most do. But what I found out is that you use PowerPoint, people begin to check out. I want you to take notes. I want you to have lots of notes. Like I said before, I'm going to give you the how in your business. And the only way that I can give you the how is if you actually write it down and put it in your notes. So hopefully you've got your notebook with you and you can begin taking notes. So let's talk about systems for a moment. I like to define a system as anything that saves you stress, time, energy, and money. A system is anything that saves you stress, time, energy, and money. The adverse of that is really applicable. Look in your life as to what is causing you the most stress. Look in your life as to what is zapping your energy. Look in your business or in your life as to what is costing you the most money. And in those areas where you're losing out on your stress is increasing, you're losing out on your time, your energy is zapped and it's costing you money, and that's where you don't have a system. I do a lot of traveling, so one of the things that I've done is I've created a system for when I travel. So I have a specific suitcase that I use for my travel. I really don't have to pack it. It's pretty much all packed itself. I come home, you know, I send it through the wash, and then I can leave it right there. I know exactly. All of my toiletries are already packed. When I walk into my hotel room, I've got a place for my wallet. I've got a place for my key. You might say, this guy is OCD. I see some of you OCD on your badge. I appreciate that. Yes. It's a system. When I go to checkout, I don't have to worry. Do I have everything? I know where I put everything in my hotel room, so I don't have to stress about it. I don't have to call the hotel 2 days later and say, hey, did I leave my cell phone there or my cell phone charger? So anything that is costing you stress, time, energy, and money is where you lack a system. Now, here's what I know about your membership business. You're losing out on money, and you don't even know it because you don't have systems. You're having to guess at what you're going to do from 1 month to the next because you don't have a system. You're having to guess on what you're going to do with your members because you don't have a system. So let's name some systems. And we won't use the mic, you can just shout it out really loud. What are some systems that we have that we've grown up with or that we've been taught? Name some systems.
McDonald's
has a system, that's right. They've built an entire restaurant chain off of systems. All we want you to do is flip hamburgers. Somebody else is gonna do all of this. What are some other systems? Online banking has a system. You guys have gone complex really quick. UPS has systems. Let's dumb it down just a little bit. What are some systems that you were taught in third grade? What's that? The Dewey Decimal System. Line up and wait your turn. How about this one? I was discussing this one earlier with Chris. What about the solar system, right? We're taught there's a solar system. We're also taught in biology that there are systems in what? It's systems in our body. So let's name some of those systems that are in our body. What are some of those systems that we've got? Now everybody's saying circulatory system, right? That system is running in our body. It's pumping the blood. It's getting into our organs. Right now, just after lunch, that blood is rushing to your stomach, pumping it in there to help your what system? Digestive system. That's right. And so your digestive system is turning that system into energy so that you can build up your immune system. That's good. And so you have an immune system that is working to keep you healthy and keep all of the other organs in your body healthy and functioning correctly. And you have a muscular system. Now, I know that's the most obvious system on my body. That's why I'm up here. You have a muscular system. You have a skeletal system. You have a nervous system. You have I always forget this one. Integumentary system. Anybody know what that one is? Integumentary system. You have an integumentary system that is your fingernails and your hair and your skin. I mean, unbelievable. We have systems, and all of these systems are working together in order to keep us healthy. We need systems in order to be healthy. Our body is built off of it. Our solar system is built off of it. I believe that every system conducts health and growth. So if you want a healthy and growing membership business, you have to have systems. You have to have systems in place to make that happen. Healthy things grow. Healthy things grow. As a matter of fact, from the very time you're born, you're fighting off disease. From the very time you are born, you're fighting off disease. That's it. That's what we spend the rest of our life doing, is trying to stay healthy. I mean, the very act of nature against us is trying to drag us down. And as we get older, I mean, things start to go. I turned 40, and all of a sudden, I'm starting to see, you know, my hair is starting to recede a little bit. I'm starting to look like my dad. I don't like that. You know, all of a sudden, my immune system isn't functioning like it should be. I've got to work on my immune system and stay healthy. My metabolism all of a sudden has changed, and now I've got to do this like shake diet that I drink every morning and every afternoon, and then I pig out for dinner, right? You're born, and then you're fighting off disease. Or what I like to think of is that you're fighting off dis-ease. That's really what it is. You're fighting off dis-ease. So in your membership business, in your real estate investing business, those things that make you uneasy, you're constantly trying to fight it off. And when you have a system in place, it makes it easier to do, because when you have systems, you have growth and you have health. So what does all this talk about systems mean for your membership business? I've identified seven of them. I'm going to share all seven of them with you today. I'm not going to be able to give you all seven during our time together when I talk about the how, but I will talk about the two most important, and if I have time, I will talk about a third one that will also benefit you over the next 2 days that we have together. So what does all this talk about systems mean? Here's the first one of the seven systems of a growing membership business. It's the content system. This is what and how you will provide and when. Now, you might think of content immediately. For some of you, your brain might immediately just go to content as something that you will teach. But it's not just what you will teach. It will be also the menu of services that you provide. Your Home Depot benefit is one of your pieces of content. It is unique to what you are able to do for your members. So we're going to unpack this system on content today, because I told you at the end of today, my goal is for you to have an entire year planned for your members. So there's the content system. There's the assimilation system. What do you want your members to receive, believe, and achieve? Here's what I know about every membership business. How many of you are a member of something, a gym, or you know, Netflix, or I mean any sort of membership? Okay? Here's what I know what happens when you join a membership. That membership business owner, just like when somebody joins your REA, they look at you, all of a sudden they say, you're a member. You're now a member. Congratulations, you made a great decision. You're now a member of my membership business. Here's what I know about that person. They're thinking, I really just made a transaction. I bought a membership. I don't yet feel like a member. I've not really utilized my membership yet. I don't know that, you know, how this thing is going to work. Really, I'm just a customer. And so when your people who join your membership program come to you, they have a set of beliefs that are different than what your REA may teach. So when somebody says, hey, I want to get involved in real estate investing, I've read a couple of books and I've done this and I heard this speaker over here, and all of a sudden they name drop a speaker that like just teaches like junk that REA doesn't teach, and all of a sudden you're thinking, oh, I'm going to have to do a lot to change their beliefs. I've got to get them to believe something different. Somebody joins your REA and is just looking at the shiny object thinking they're going to get rich quick. You're thinking, oh gosh, I've got to handle this again. I've got to change their beliefs that this isn't just going to be some get-rich-quick scheme that they can be a part of. So there's a set of beliefs that you've all got to indoctrinate your new members with. So what do you want them to receive? What do you want them to receive in the first hour of joining your membership? What do you want them to receive in the first 24 hours of joining your membership? What do you want them to receive within the first week, the first month, the first quarter, the first 6 months, the first year? And by the way, when they get to their 1 year membership, and this is a big problem for many of you, you don't tell them, hey, your annual membership is now due. You don't tell them, hey, you've been with us for a year, it's time to renew. All of a sudden, what you do is you've put that time frame on them, and they're now thinking, do I really want to do this again? I don't know that I see the value that I once did. I don't know that I want to continue that direction. So what do you want them to receive? And then what do you want them to achieve? From the time a member joins your membership program, when do you want them to have their first success? When do you want them to do their first real estate investment? How long is that process for them that you can take them from being a member to getting involved and actually utilizing their membership? Now, we're going to spend most likely tomorrow unpacking the assimilation system into greater detail. So my goal for you is that you have a step-by-step process which you can assimilate members and keep them for the long haul. that you know exactly what you're going to do when somebody joins your membership. Instead of just patting them on the back and saying, hey, our next meeting is on, you know, July 17th. We're going to meet at the Holiday Inn. Hope you'll be there. I want you to do better than that. Because when you get a member and you get them utilizing their membership quickly, you'll assimilate them more quickly, you'll get them to success more quickly, and they'll enjoy their membership. They'll see the value in it and get immediate benefit. The third system is the marketing system. The marketing system. So how do you identify the right message delivered with the right media to the right market? Now, I will admittedly say I did not make this up. I got this from a friend of mine, Dan Kennedy. Some of you may be familiar with him. Some of you may even be a member of GKIC, of which is one of my private clients. So taking the message, the market, and the media, and identifying your unique selling proposition, your USP. What makes you, your RIA, different? I mean, admittedly, there's a number of organizations out there. There are a number of how-tos out there. I've heard even some of you say today that you've got competitors in your area that are, you know, competing with you. So what makes you unique? We'll point this out in the content system. What separates your membership program apart from all of the others? That's part of the marketing system. If you've not seen this before, go ahead and draw a triangle in your notes. It doesn't have to be that large, just a small triangle. And here's what you do with the marketing system. You've got your message, your market, and you've got your media. And when all of these are right, you've got a balanced, healthy system for your marketing. You don't have an awkward triangle. You've hit it right in the center with your message, market, and media. When you say, hey, you know, we did email marketing or we did Facebook marketing to try to get new members and it didn't work. I can tell you it didn't work. It's not because Facebook marketing doesn't work. It's not because LinkedIn marketing doesn't work. It's because the way you did it doesn't work. It was either your message didn't match the media. It didn't match the target audience, your market. And so when you do a marketing promotion or a marketing piece, and all of a sudden you're not seeing your ROI on that piece, it is because one of these three didn't line up. So you have the right message, the wrong market, the right media, it's not going to work. You have the right message, right market, wrong media, not going to work. And any combination of those, the only one that works is when you take the right message to the right market, to the right media, it'll produce great results. You're not going to get it right every time. That's why you test it. That's why you go back and say, what can we do to improve this system? So that's the marketing system. The next system is the retention system. The retention system. Now, we're not going to cover this in detail during our time together. And here's why. Because most membership business owners, they immediately want to go to retention and saying, we're not keeping our members. My goal to help you increase your retention during our time together is going to come through the content system and through the assimilation system and through a session on what I call why people quit, which obviously deals directly with retention. So the retention system is all about creating a membership path where you have your people believe, belong, and become your ideal member. Think for a moment. Think for a moment. Every RIA has it. Who is your ideal member? This is one of the questions I asked Rebecca. She's paying me big money not to share that name, by the way, on who her ideal member is. Who's your ideal member? They have a set of certain beliefs. They have a certain way of going about and saying they belong to RIA and they feel connected to your RIA. They are saying, I'm becoming something greater than I would separate from my from this RIA, from this organization, from this association. So you look at your ideal member, and there's a pathway that you can take your new member to get them to become your ideal member. And then there's also a pathway to say your ideal member, where they are, they haven't achieved ultimate success yet. There's a pathway even for them. And see, for some of you, your RIAs are successful, but then you've got this problem on the back end where your successful members, they're starting to drop out. They're starting to see less value because even as you say it, they're an advanced investor. They're more immediate. They don't want to be around the newbies. They want to be around others. And if all they're around are the newbies, or you know, they're only seeing the legislative announcements that we bring forward, and that's the only value that our advanced investors are getting, you're not giving them much of a reason, much of a pathway for them to stay with you. So, what do you want your members to believe, belong, become, and creating a membership pathway for them? The next system, system number 5, if you're taking notes and counting numbers, is the ascension system. The ascension system. This is all about creating an ascension ladder within your membership business. Many of you only have one rung on the ladder. It's a member. That's it. But you've identified people in your membership business who are at different levels in real estate investing, but you don't quite have a membership for them yet because you've only got one membership. Or for some of you, you've got 2 levels of membership. I was talking with somebody on yesterday. They have 3 levels of membership. I personally like 3 levels of membership, and I'll tell you why. First, let me tell you about the ladder. On this right here, you've got ascension. That is a rung on the ladder. That is a rung on the ladder. Then on this one right here, if you're drawing this in your notes, you've got descension. I'll tell you about descension in a moment. Then on the 2 side rails, you've got achievement and retention. You've got achievement and retention. So let's start first with ascension. You always want to be moving your members towards something. If your members aren't moving towards something, they're going to get stagnant. They're going to get discontent. They're not going to see the value. They're not going to see the benefit. So members, regardless of the membership business, always have to be doing, always have to be moving. Just like our systems. If I sit back and all I do is sleep, my systems are going to start deteriorating. You've got to keep your members active and moving. You've got to be able to know what members showed up for what meetings and who didn't show up and have that process to be able to move them along and always keep members engaged and involved in your membership program. And so one way that you do that through ascension is you tell them there's always a next step for you. Even your advanced investors, there's a next step for you. There's another rung on the ladder. There's another opportunity for you to do greater, do better, be better, gain more, whatever it is that they're seeking. So ascension, always a next rung. Then the bottom rungs, that bottom arrow, is a descension. If you start right now, when somebody quits, and you offer them a downgrade in their membership, you'll start increasing your retention quickly. If you just say, you know, I understand you're not utilizing your membership, but we have these things over here, and you're saying, well, what are those things? We'll talk about it in the content system. And you say, here it is. We've got this membership just for you that you can stay engaged. You can still receive this content. You can still receive these benefits from us as a member on the bottom rung, which you don't tell them they're on the bottom rung, they'll say yes. They'll say yes. Now, they're not all going to say yes, but it's better than just saying, well, thanks, I won't charge your credit card anymore. Thanks for being a member. Just know you're always welcome back. If you really believe that real estate investing can help people, if you really believe that real estate investing is an opportunity for people to do better with their finances, to have better families, to provide better housing in your communities, whatever it is that you have in an innate belief about real estate investing, if you really believe that, how dare you let somebody quit your membership business? You ought to have that deep conviction that for me to let that member go is to do a disservice to them. It's to let them to continue to struggle. It's to continue to let them flounder. It's to continue to let them be less than what I know that they're capable of. How dare you just let them quit if you really believe in your membership business? Now, I hope that's where you are. I hope that you believe in your membership business so much. In my conversations with Rebecca, that's what she believes about National. That National has the opportunity to help you and to change your life and to do greater in your communities. And that National, being at the top, is able to have an influence and an impact that they could never have apart or separate from you. So, I have a strong conviction when I talk to membership businesses. I take on your beliefs. I believe in your business. I may believe in your business. For some of you, I may believe in your business even more than you do. So, having the descension, giving them the opportunity to descend in your membership program as opposed to just jumping off the ladder. Then you've got the movement of retention and ascent and achievement. That there ought to be some sort of achievement and recognition for people who do things and take action as part of their membership. That there ought to be all of these ribbons that I see. Like, I don't know what all these ribbons are that you guys are walking around with, but man, like, they did something to get those ribbons. It may have been something very small and insignificant, but man, they got that ribbon, and they should be proud. You should, if you're not doing that with your RIA when you go home, just start adding ribbons to people's name badges. You'll immediately start seeing people act differently. I mean, they're acting differently around here without looking at anybody or pointing fingers. I mean, there's a sense of pride. I'm going to hold my head up high. For me, if I was wearing one, golly, man, it would cover my gut. That'd be great. They want that. You want that. Go buy your ribbons off of the front there. They'll sell them to you, I'm sure. Your membership business is not as profitable as it could be because you're not giving members the opportunity to ascend and descend. That's the ascension system. The next system is the strategy system. The system focuses in on the tweaks. What tweaks can we make to increase our membership, increase retention, reduce cancellations, create more profit? I like to think of it as, what is the constant and never-ending improvement inside my business that I can make? That I'm not just going to be satisfied. I'm not just going to set the wheel in motion. That wheel in motion constantly has to be pushed. It has to be turned. Things constantly have to be dialed back in to make sure. So what is that so that complacency doesn't set into my business? Some of you are at places right now where your membership business isn't growing. You've got the same number of members or less even than you did last year. And so they're stagnant. Well, it's because you don't have a system, a strategy system to put in place to constantly put things in motion. What are the four most valuable questions you can use to evaluate your membership program? That's part of the strategy system. Creating a membership culture. Having cancellation strategies, acquisition strategies, pricing strategies, and then numbers you need to know for the health and growth of your business. That's all part of the strategy system. If I was to ask you right now, how many members canceled last year in your membership program? Without a doubt, you know that number. Raise your hand. I see one, two, three, four. Really? That many? You were in a membership business. I mean, only four people in this room know how many members canceled last year? Now, for some of you, that might be like, I don't really want to know that number. Well, don't run from that number. You want to grow your business? You want to change people's lives? You want to do better? You ought to know that number. You know, if I was to say, you know, how many of you know the attendance number at the last event that you held, you'd probably know that. How many of you know that, right? Wow, please, tell me more. Okay, there's more. You need to know your numbers. You need to know how many people canceled. You need to know how many people joined. You need to know the difference between the two in your retention rate of how many people joined last month versus canceled last month, or how many people joined last year versus joining this year. Are we on track to do better in the way of more new members this year than members that canceled last year? See, most people think, well, I just want to get more members this year than I got last year. That's a good number to know. But in a membership business, if you don't keep an eye on your retention rate, having more members join this year than canceled last year, you're not going to be growing. Doesn't matter if you got more members, you could still be flat even at the end of the year based on your cancellations. So the strategy system is all about the numbers you need to know and constant and never-ending improvement. And then there's the leadership system. Growing businesses are led by growing leaders. Growing businesses are led by growing leaders. What you're doing here today is part of your leadership system. You're taking time out to go to work on your business instead of in your business. You're here to learn from others. You're here to hear other success stories, tools and items that you can go back. How many of you have already learned something that you said, you know what, I learned something from another Rhea that I'm going to be able to go back and put and implement in my business? Raise your hand. See? As part of your leadership system, you've got to have this. You've got to have this. And not just this, you ought to be looking at other membership organizations and saying, what can I learn from them? What other conferences can I attend? I break down the leadership system into the letters of lead. What are you learning? What are you experiencing? Experience is not the best teacher. Evaluated experience is the best teacher. Evaluated experience. You go into a meeting, you say, well, that meeting went great. Next one is on July 17th. Let's go for it. Well, just because you had a great meeting one time doesn't mean that next month's meeting is going to be great. You go into the meeting on July 17th and say, man, that meeting was horrible. I hope next month isn't like that. And then you go into the August meeting, August 16th. It's here. Is it going to be good? Is it going to be bad like last month? Well, I don't know. Let's just roll the dice. Evaluated experience. Things change. People change. Your events are going to change. So how do you constantly lead those events and lead yourself to improve them? I'll give you four questions. I shouldn't do this. It's part of the strategy system. But I'm going to help you in your meetings. You want four questions that will help improve every meeting that you do? You want it? Yeah. What went right? It's not on the notes. What went right? After every meeting that you have, you ought to ask, what went right? You ought to get your board together if there's a board. You ought to get your staff together if there's a staff. You ought to say, what went right? Celebrate it. You worked hard to put that meeting on. You think these things happen by chance? No, they don't. It takes work to put it on. I understand that. Your staff understands that. Celebrate it. The next one is, what went wrong? What went wrong? Well, the speaker was too boring. He was too dry. You know, it was all about sales to the back of the room. We'll never have him back again. I heard somebody say in the back there about, you know, what do you do with your microphone and sound system? It crashed on us. How do we correct that? I mean, part of what you guys were doing previously was about that question. What's wrong in your business? What went wrong with that meeting? What was missing? What was missing? You come out of a meeting and you say, man, we didn't have the signage. We were missing this at the registration table. You know, we thought we'd have Wi-Fi provided to us, but we didn't have Wi-Fi. That was missing. You know all of those things. I mean, they were missing, but nobody made a list of it for the next meeting. And you go into the next meeting, it's like, well, registration tables were still missing some stuff. Wi-Fi still wasn't available, all that. And you're blaming it on the location. It's not their problem. It's yours. What was missing? And then what was confusing? What went right? What went wrong? What was missing? What was confusing? Some of the reasons why people may be leaving your events early is just because it's confusing. It's confusing. And well, you might say, well, how? Well, maybe your schedule isn't clear. Maybe something happened that they thought, well, you know what? We're about to end. You ever been in a meeting like that? You might be thinking that even now, like, okay, can I get out of here early? You know? So they're thinking, hey, what can I do to get out of here? Oh, okay, they're gonna end at this time, and so then they go off. No. So what was confusing about your event? What went right, what went wrong, what was missing, and what was confusing? Now, if you do just those four things, that's gonna help you even further than what you're already doing, but I'll take it one step further for you, and that is assign someone to the wrong, missing, confusing. It's one thing for you to say, okay, hey, we evaluated it, but you've got to do something with that evaluation. You've got to say, hey, we can't just say, well, the internet was there, we were missing this at the registration table, all of this was confusing. You got to say, okay, who's going to take responsibility for the registration table? Who's going to make sure that next month that's not missing? Who's going to be responsible for next month making sure that we've got this set up? Who's going to be responsible for making sure that we do a better job at, you know, critiquing our speakers before we even put them up on stage? You do those things, now you've got a system. You've got a system in place that after every event, you're going to send out this questionnaire to the people who help you put this on. And for some of you, it may just be you and your spouse. You're the only two doing it. Or it's just a handful of people. But man, you're going to have so much less stress when it comes to that event. You're going to have so much less energy being exerted because now you've got a system to evaluate it. So evaluated experience is the best teacher. So lead, you've got learning, experiencing, and then what are you applying and developing? What are you applying and developing? It is one thing for you to be here today, over the next couple of days, to get all this great information. But what are you going to apply in your business? What are you going to develop? My goal for you is that you'll leave here with an understanding, a better understanding of your membership business, and that you will seek to grow your membership business alongside your real estate investing business. And that you'll look out for the best interest of your members, that you'll have them in mind, that you'll look to get more new members, increase your retention, and keep people from quitting. So when you have these seven systems, you'll have a healthy, growing, and profitable membership business. When they're all at work together, there's going to be health. There'll be growth. You'll be getting new members. You'll be keeping people longer. You'll be able to help people overcome cancellations and objections for leaving your membership because you've got a system in place that is reducing your stress, giving you more time, more freedom to be able to work on other things, to enjoy your family, whatever hobbies you may have. And that, yes, my goal, one of my goals for you is for you to earn more money as a result of your membership business. Now, I know that we have some nonprofits in here. You might say, well, we're not a profit. We're a nonprofit. We don't earn money. I want you to think about it this way as a nonprofit. You're going to be able to help more members by getting more money in your membership business. It will enable you to help more members, more people. So I told you I'm a pastor. In my opinion, the church, the Christian church, is the best and longest running membership business there is. And that churches aren't after your money. We don't need your money. It doesn't need my money. But in order for us to help as many people as possible, it takes money. So we have certain things in place. And I also believe that God designed us and designed His church so that we give toward it. It's a biblical mandate. So for you as a nonprofit, you need to have more money so that you can help more people. Your membership business is only as stable as your weakest system. So let's answer these two questions. What is your strongest system and what is your weakest system? What is your strongest system and what is your weakest system? I'll give you a moment to reflect. You might say, well, what are those seven systems again? They are content system. Assimilation, a content system is all about what you will provide, when you will provide it, how you will provide it. Your assimilation system, how you'll take somebody from being a new member to being fully engaged in your membership business. Your marketing system and identifying the right market, the right media, the right message. Your retention system as to what you want your people to believe, belong, and become so that they stay even longer. Your ascension system in giving people an opportunity to ascend in your membership program or descend in your membership program. Your strategy system about how you constantly and never-ending improvement in your business and your leadership system. So I am going to take a risk. Is there anybody brave enough to share what your strongest system is? What do you think it is? Shout it out.
Sales.
Sales, marketing?
Yeah, well, sales.
Okay, out of these seven systems, because you're talking about functions and activities that fall under one of these systems. So what is one of the seven systems I named, what is your strongest that you've got? The content? Okay. I thought you said accounting. I'm sorry. Yeah, content. I heard somebody over here. Content system. I'm going to challenge you guys on that. What else? Marketing. All right. What is your weakest system? All of them. All the others, right? Ascension. I would honestly, for many of you, I would think ascension would probably be one that there's a lot of room and opportunity for. What others? Weakest? Assimilation. Man, I'd be honest, I love assimilation. It's my favorite system out of all of them.
Retention.
Okay. We're going to hit on that when we talk about why people quit. So I like to think of every business is able to have a membership aspect to it until I came across this cartoon. He says, I've got to say, the idea of a divorce lawyer with a rewards program is unusual, right? Luckily, you don't have to. Any lawyers in the room by any chance? Are, well, gosh. Divorce lawyer? Yeah, I know. So, let's dive in on content, and let's talk about your content. I'm glad to hear that some of you think it is the strongest system. I hope it is. I also hope to give you some tools that you can use even further in developing your content. I really do believe there's nothing that sets another organization apart from you other than your content. They can assimilate the members in the same way. They can do marketing the same way you do marketing. They can set in, you know, retention in the same way you set in retention. They can provide ascension for their members. They can do things on strategy and leadership within their business. But when it's all said and done, what separates you from your competition is content. It's also what makes up what you do. It's also what your marketing system is relying upon, and you being able to take this content and services and being able to articulate it in such a way that it's going to show benefits for people to join your membership business. So let's break it down. First, you have your content catalog. Your content catalog. We're going to talk about this. You guys are going to do some work at your tables on developing the content catalog, and because it's a national, we're going to share your content catalog that you develop at your table. I'm going to share it from the stage up here so that you'll all be able to have the content catalog from one another. And so you will never guess at what content you've got or what value you can bring to your members. That's why I'll always start with the content, because I want you to know very clearly what you're going to have. And not just having a catalog of all of the services, all of the things that you can teach, and all that you provide, but I want you to be able to categorize it. I want you to be able to say that, okay, there's this content over here that fits in this category. There's this content over here that is in this category. Those of you who said that your content system is your strongest system, great. Let's categorize it, because what I found is that sometimes your content is too heavy on one side. It's not evenly spread out. So there may be too many national speakers coming in, that all of a sudden is causing confusion within your members, because you've got so many national speakers coming in, they're all coming in with different messages, there's no uniformity, and well, now your members are wondering, okay, who do I believe? What guru do I follow? What expert do I get their product from? You know, what system do I put in place for my real estate investing? And then, just to say it, when they try it and it fails, well, they blame you. You brought that speaker in. So we're going to categorize it and make sure that you have a healthy balance to your content. And then we're going to put it on a calendar. Now, hopefully you have a calendar on your cell phone. Some of you have your computers. That's great. If not, you'll be able to just put the months out there. Even if you don't put the dates down, but I hope you will put the dates down and go ahead and set the dates for the next year for your meetings so that you have an entire year. I heard somebody say, we've got meetings already planned through the end of December. That's great. Let's do it for next year now. Let's utilize this time so that you'll never have to guess for the next year, and that when you guys come back together next year, you do it again. Utilize this time to put a one-year calendar together of all of the meetings that you're going to have. And then I'll answer some other questions about how the content system works together and then why people quit in your content. So that's everything that we'll cover in the content system. So let's talk about your content catalog. Do we have the mic? Let's get the mic. I want to hear from you. As you would define it, what is Rhea passionate about? What is your Rhea passionate about? If you had to say to me, I told you already at the beginning. We're going to do it by the mic. If you had to get me to join your membership program, if you had to get me to join your real estate investing association, if I lived in your community and you said, you know what, you really ought to get involved in real estate, which, by the way, I'm actually like thinking like about. It's like, okay, you know, maybe I should go back to Charleston and look at doing this. What would you say that Rhea is passionate about? We got one behind you.
We'll connect you faster, better, and more than any other competitor in the market.
Okay.
To all the resources a real estate investor must have to be successful.
What else? How would you articulate it for your Rhea? If I came into your town, your city, said I'm considering joining your Rhea.
We're all about education, so that you learn as many ways to get in and out of real estate, no matter what the economy does.
Okay, great. Opportunities.
We provide a receptive atmosphere for learning from other people's experiences.
Great. So I'm not going to be some weirdo who's out there putting up signs and, like, you know, I buy houses for cash or anything like that. I'm going to be accepted by people who think like I do, who want to do business like I do.
You did or didn't?
I did.
Yeah, and I can put up signs, by the way.
I would say integrity and success in education is what we promote mostly with our members.
Great. It's not a scheme.
Building generational wealth and using real estate as a vehicle.
Great. I can leave a legacy to my two young daughters. Get them involved.
We have developed an acronym 5 years ago called ELM. That stands for an ELM tree, which is education, legislation, and membership benefits.
Great. Anybody else? All right, what is Rhea good at? Let's share the mic on that. Everybody's hands should go up there now. I mean, come on. This is, what are you good at?
Hang on, I got the answer to that right now.
Oh yeah?
Here it comes.
All right, bringing you the most brilliant minds and ideas in real estate.
I love that. You guys just ought to write that down right now. Most brilliant minds in real estate.
And ideas.
What else? All right, we've got some work to do. We'll get you on mic.
Connecting people of like minds together.
Okay, great. What else are you guys good at?
Sharing experiences and teaching others.
This is how you do it. Mentoring.
Measuring?
No, mentoring.
Mentoring, okay.
Being a mentor to people that are brand new in the business, taking our knowledge and experience that we have, our expertise, and teaching to others.
Good.
I tell people that you don't join your association because of benefits. You join because you want to be around people that are like you, that talk like you, that think like you, and that are going to encourage you to be your best you. And our community is the largest community like ours in Washington.
Great, great. I would challenge you on, it is a benefit. It is a benefit though. For me to have the affinity and the like-mindedness and to challenge me, I mean, it's a benefit that you're gonna make me better. Just one moment. Let me just say this. The very basic need, the very lowest level need that everybody joins a membership program is selfishness. I'll call it like I see it. Selfishness. I want something, or I want to become something, or I want to be like something, or I want to be around others who have. I want to have this affinity. I want to be a part of. It is all about some innate selfish desire that they have that you can provide. That's why people join membership programs. That's why you join. That's why you're part of RIA. They provide something that you want. That's why you're providing a membership program, because you found people who want something that you've got. Good.
I'm glad you said that. What I was going to say is, or what I'm saying is, that we provide the opportunity for people to create something for themselves through that selfish need, whatever that might be, whether it's belonging, whether it's wanting to create financial freedom, to create a legacy, etc. So.
Yeah. Basically, we have to get good at working with selfish people. That's what it is.
I would say keeping up with the changes, whether they're market changes, legislative changes. We're in a constant flux with real estate investing.
Yeah, I've heard a great deal about the legislative part. I think that is awesome. I was able to hear, and not to say anything about what's going to happen after my session today, but like, you guys ought to really stay in for the legislative portion that's going to happen right after I get done, because like they're working on your behalf, and they're working in DC and on the local level with your state representatives, and you really need to get involved more on the legislative side as well, so that you'll be able to continue to do and offer what you do and offer. All right, so let's do this.
Can we have one more?
One more, go ahead.
All right.
No, it's pretty close to what he was saying, just the unity and strength to come together to make a difference in legislation.
Yep.
Instead of by ourselves.
Yeah, can't do it individually. So how are you helping others achieve what you've achieved? How are you helping others achieve what you've achieved? What is it that you've done in the past, I'll be generous, the past 6 months? I'd like for you to know in the past month, by the way. If you want to be really aggressive, what did you do in the past month that helped a member? But what did you do? What did you do in the past 6 months that helped somebody who's a member of your membership program? We'll take the mic.
I'm on my way, Jane. Let's stop right here.
This morning, one of my members had emailed me and asking about a situation on a probate property. So I guided them to file a notice of interest because they were afraid another investor was going to steal it. So I gave them some free information that created a solution for their problem and gave them the conference that they were looking for.
Great.
The assurance they needed.
Great.
Help them connect with someone who could answer their problems or questions.
Good.
Perfect. I love it.
Well, I broke into a vacant house with one of our members and helped them flip a property and make a $20,000 wholesale flip fee.
Wow. Great. I'm starting to hear a mumble. Like, that is probably better than I just realized. Is that right? I've seen people... Yeah. Oh, break into a house? Oh.
Speak a little bit louder.
You guys, I told you I know nothing about real estate. I'm depending upon you guys.
What was your name again?
Yeah. Get him on video, right?
I took two new members, green to investing, and showed them the five most influential people in our area, and introduced them to them personally, and then took them out for dinner a couple days later, sat down and talked with them, and gave them that, hey, we're here to help feeling.
Great, great.
So you tried to show them what they may be looking for, not what you had.
Exactly.
Great. I hope that you guys are also saying, you know, that you've got the success story of, you know, in the past 3 months, I was able to help X number of people do their first deal, you know. Or I was able to, I heard five, somebody being an advanced investor would be, you know, having done five deals. So I helped X number of people do five deals within the past couple months.
I started a book club in our club. We hadn't had one before, and we're currently reading Landlording on Autopilot by Mike Butler.
Great.
I think something that I'm really good at is just being a good listener. When people just want to come and talk to you and tell you what they're experiencing, and then maybe you can provide some empathy.
Good. So let me ask this question. We're not going to use the mic on it. I want you to reflect on it. What content do you have that is already helping others? What content do you have that is already helping others? I hope that as you utilize the content system, you'll think back at, you know, okay, this piece of content here, and as we lay it out for you in our time together, that this content right here is really what every new investor should go through. This content right here is what every growing investor, somebody who's moving up the realm a little bit, and then here's what every advanced investor should go through, and that you'll be able to identify that pathway for them to be able to grow and to do more with your content. What services do you provide? What services do you provide? What products do you provide? Now comes the fun part. I want to give you some time at your tables, and I want you to write down your content catalog. utilizing these two questions. What services do you provide? What products do you provide? Now, don't get hung up on products in the sense of, you know, we got this package CD, DVD training course over here or something like that. It doesn't have to be just that. It's some sort of product material that you can point people in. It's, you know, the book club could fall underneath that everybody's got to go out and get that particular book. So you've got access to other people's content as part of that. So let's take a moment. You've got the big flip charts at your table. I hope that you'll utilize those. You've also got some plain white paper. I'm going to utilize the plain white paper up here on the Elmo so that everybody can see. So make sure the person with the best handwriting does that, unlike my handwriting. So go ahead and volunteer that person. And let's answer these two questions as to what products and what services you provide. And I'll make my way around. I'll gather the paper in a few minutes. So somebody just asked a question, I'll clarify. You are developing your content catalog here. So this is everything you provide. What products, what services you provide, this is your content catalog.